A lot of news developments are called game changers. And one of the biggest ways to change the game is change the rules of the game. And in the wake of a Supreme Court ruling on June 28th, the rules of the game are changing, especially for regulatory agencies like the SEC. We're headed into a new era of court oversight of regulatory agencies. And one area where we might see a lot of changes is in startup fundraising. Let's dive in. First off, the basics. Regulatory agencies get their power from laws passed by Congress. Congress will pass a statute giving an agency the power to regulate different industries. For example, the EPA for the environment, FCC for broadcasting, or the SEC for investment transactions, and so on and so on. And since 1984, these regulatory agencies have had a lot of latitude in what they've been able to regulate. This was under a doctrine you may have heard of called the Chevron deference. And under Chevron, a court would defer to an agency's interpretation of a statute. This, of course, as long as that interpretation seemed to be reasonable. Well, last week, the Supreme Court overturned that Chevron doctrine, creating a much wider role for courts to oversee regulatory agencies. This change could have a profound impact on the way that courts and regulators interact with each other and the powers that each body has. Let's specifically look at what this means for small business or entrepreneurship. In 2012, Congress passed the Jobs Act, which was then signed into law by President Obama. The Jobs Act loosened laws and regulations around startup fundraising and the ability of a business to raise capital from investors. Congress would actually give the SEC the power to create regulations that would balance between allowing more startups to be able to fundraise and making that easier with the public interest and public safety in mind. The SEC would respond by requiring these startups to disclose more information than they previously had to. The SEC also left in place certain state regulations on startup fundraising. So these SEC regulations and the interpretation of the Jobs Act actually led to a limited use of fundraising capabilities created by the Jobs Act. So now back to the Supreme Court overruling of Chevron. There could be a rise of new court challenges to those original SEC provisions. It now may be up to the courts to decide if the SEC went too far in their added provisions or regulatory agency on the Jobs Act, or was it a correct interpretation totally within their bounds? It's truly impossible to say actually how this will change the industry, but what we do know is that startups and small business is the heartbeat of the American economy. So let's hope regulators and judges can strike that balance between supporting the small business owners and entrepreneurs that are kind of the bleeding heart of the US, as well as protecting investors and those same entrepreneurs.